a piece of wood is not only a piece of wood, it's a piece of our salary. It is what we get paid for.
This is small-scale industry that we know will grow rapidly.
We build a lot of tall timber structures using cross-laminated timber panels.
When we have to dry the wood, depends on the method we use when we're drying.
What you are doing in the wood, you should know how this has an impact on the usability of the wood.
The guidelines for grading timber and the quality is found in this book.
And the whole chain from planting to good quality is a very important item in this case.
The TreProX project is cooperation between three countries, that is Iceland, Denmark and Sweden. The aim of the project is to obtain material to enable farmers in Iceland and in other countries to get quality timber from their forests. We already have a book that has been translated from Swedish into Icelandic, and that's about quality timber. Also during the project, we are working on standards for poplars. That's a new thing, it hasn't been done before. In addition to that, we in Iceland, we have a curriculum for forest farmers, and that will be one of our contributions to the project. Today we have 35 participants that have already arrived in Iceland, and probably some more will add to the group as we go along. The agenda for this week is very diverse, and we hope that the weather will be nice the whole time.
You are in the beginning, and we people who work in this industry, we believe in what we are doing. Yeah, we believe in wood. We see that wood and pieces of wood, it doesn't matter. It is a material for the future.
Mm. Yeah, welcome to him. 1,000 hectares of planted forest, about 1,000 hectares of woodland.
Forest management has an impact on the usability of the wood. And different thinnings and how you reforest your land, how this will have an impact on the wood quality. I have some focus on good quality, but it doesn't have to be the best quality. It could be also be the right quality, but you should know what you are doing in the wood and how this will impact the usability and the quality of different species and different times in wood.
I've been working with sawmilling for a good deal of my life, and the specific reason is I have had a lesson about how to increase quality in the wood products here in Iceland. Iceland have now reached a state where it's possible to mill some of the trees that comes out of the forest, and the whole chain from planting to good quality is a very important item in this case.
If you don't want to clear cut, you can use continuous forest cavalry. But if you chose one of those or both of those methods, you have to take care of different species conditions to come out with the best yield from different management system you can create in the forest. It seems that many people have forgotten how to do this in the best way.
It starts, as you said, in a forest, to do the best you can there, and then the logs come to the sawmill, and then a new kind of process starts up, and when everything is produced, it's splitted, it's sorted, then a new process is started up. So it's like a link, and to understand what happened in all these links, yeah, not only to be there, it's good to know what happened from the start to the beginning, yeah.
From being a country with more or less no trees at all, we have forests here, we have sawmills here, we have drying kilns here, we have production of building products. And for one thing, one product coming out of these forests is bio-based fuel, biofuel from the forests, which can be combined with the geothermal energy here, so that by using geothermal heat, we can dry the biofuel. And in that respect, Iceland will be able to actually export geothermal energy to the rest of the world to help reduce the climate change that we are experiencing at the moment.
They are measuring CO2 emissions from ground and from different types of plants. All the research here is put into contact with global warming.
The difference between coniferous trees and broadleaf trees is coniferous, you might say that the cell wall have a density, quite high density. And then we looked a little bit at the water in the wood. When you are felling tree in the forest, when it's growing in summertime, it's maybe 50% of the weight is water. And we have to get rid of this water. After we cut them down and make boards, then we have to dry the wood. Depends on the method we use when we're drying, if we use outdoor drying or if we go and use kiln drying.
What we have here in Iceland is a very small scale industry that is rapidly growing, where we will in a few years time see quite interesting new products and processes being developed. And for me, that works primarily with drying. It is a challenge to develop processes that are suitable for these species used here in Iceland, where we will need to use quite a lot of steam, which comes straight out of the ground in this country. And we will also use high temperature drying schedules. We will use strong conditioning schemes, also based on steam, to provide dimensional, stable, straight products with high quality.
It seems like there's better background in Iceland for raising production forest. And if you want to raise production forest, it's very important that already from the start you make clear what is the end product you want, where can you plant, and which type of plants can you use to get that product. So you must have that triangle in your mind whenever you start production forest.
In the year 2020, the Nordic countries, Sweden, Norway and Finland worked out a new system of rules regarding grading of soft timber. The commercial grading of timber is based on early grading rules and trial grading and was published in a book with that name and which is now also called the Black Book. Having known this new book, we decided to translate the new book into Icelandic and use it to grade timber coming from the Icelandic forest. The main difference from the Scandinavian book and ours is that we allow two types of pine and spruce and three types of larch in our book. But they only allow one type of spruce and one type of pine in theirs. The word Geithafjallir, if we translate it to English, it means quality timber. Grading in Iceland is not new. We have been grading timber for constructing. Geithafjallir are meant for timber coming from the Icelandic forest.
I'm working as a senior lecturer in Karlstad University, and I've also previously been at Linnaeus University. These are two universities that try to contribute to the development of building tall timber buildings. We have seen development in Sweden during the last 25 years. In 1995, we're not allowed to build taller than two stories in timber, but where we today see buildings up to 80 meters tall. Typically, a stud and rail system is used for building up to 4 or 5 stories tall. And when you build higher than that, normally you use cross-laminated timber panels, or CLT panels for short, that can handle forces that are quite substantial. Using that technique is more comparable with concrete, and we can see that it takes a lot of market shares from concrete structures in Sweden today. And this way is quite a nice way of utilizing timber that grows more and more at a higher speed in the forest today in Sweden and also here in Iceland.
because the sawmill industry today, it's not a kindergarten, it's a high-tech industry. It's a lot of computers and monitors. Nobody takes so much with their hands. The pieces are running in front of them. And of course, they have to be sure that everything runs well. We talk about economy, we talk about productivity, efficiency, etc., etc., etc. All this mixed together. And today, when it's high speed, it is so important that the people have the correct basic education, and they have to understand what they are doing.
Foresting in Sweden has been a little bit boring, much too standardized. You see no difference between the spruce and the spruce and the pine and the pine, but in reality there can be really big differences how you can use it, how the life age could prolong and be shorter, how sensitive the stands are for climate changes, for wind damages, insects, and so on.
It was the same situation in Sweden. I am in the forest, I'm in the paper pulp industry, I am in the sawmill industry, I'm a carpenter, I'm an end user. But today we understand that we need each other. We have to understand what we are doing. If you don't believe in what you're doing, yeah, then it's over and out. But I believe, and also a lot of friends and people I have around me, we think that this is the future. And I see that young people who grow up today, they see also again that wood, it is a natural product who goes hand by hand with the humans. Yeah, especially when we talk about our environment. Of course, we also need plastic, we need beton, we also need aluminium. But if we talk especially about our environment, wood is number one.
Now we've been here for a week with this project workshop, and it's been very interesting. We've had really good lectures and we've learned a lot from the people that have been telling us how to do things in Icelandic forests. The forests in Iceland, they are growing up quite fast. We need to thin them out, and then we need to find ways to use the timber, and to obtain quality in that timber, we need to know how. Our message to the people working in the timber industry is use the knowledge we've gained and try to increase the quality.